two on two, that's like four. They be sharing me, okay. They working like the rent dude. Rent got them doing that. That's what I'm into. Yeah. If I'm anything, I own it, not a rental. No, I've been plotting on the lamb and the Benz cool.
Yeah. We find ourselves at the stadium that played host to Super Bowl 52, the wondrous U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. Today, we reach week 15, and we've got a good matchup in store between the Green Bay Packers and the Minnesota Vikings. Strapped in, it's just about time to get the party started, and we are underway from downtown Minneapolis. And no run back on the opening kickoff. It'll come out to the 25. Cook as they begin on the ground, and he'll work this forward for about three and second down. These two teams, you may recall, they didn't play each other till late in the year. Their first meeting was not too long ago, back in week 13, and it was the visitors getting the win there, so they'll be looking for the sweep back here at home. Here's second and seven now from the 28. They run it again with Cook. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. This defense for the Packers, they put together a strong effort last week in the win over Chicago.
And every defensive team that we talk to, they spend a lot of time talking about creating turnovers. And anytime you get two or more in a game, you've had a really good performance. They exceeded that number in a huge way. They got the football back four times in the win.
And he will get him down a couple yards shy of the first down marker. A nice tackle coming up from his free safety spot. So on fourth down, on is the punter, Ryan Wright. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. Fielded at the 20. It'll be a 44-yard punt, six on the return. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. Roger, off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And he overshot in there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
And CD, you look at this defense. You know, what kind of pressure are they under trying to stop a team that has won five games in a row?
Well, to me, it makes their job harder because you know you're going up against an offense that's playing at an elite level. And sometimes you can get too caught up in trying to play the perfect game. You're trying to be too precise, too fine, instead of just letting it rip. And I think that's more the priority than trying to be absolutely perfect.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
Not a great start dropping his first target, but let's face it, it won't be his last chance because he'll get opportunities to make up for that one throughout this game.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Now Rodgers. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free. And it brings up fourth down. On fourth down, Matt Araiza is sent on the punt. Called out a 46-yard punt, though they did get nine back on the return. And it will be Vikings ball, first and 10. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. as we grind toward the end of the season here, and they haven't had the season that they had hoped. So let me ask you to play GM. Where might they look to make some changes?
I think when you look into the upcoming draft, think hard about them drafting multiple offensive linemen. They've got to get stouter up front. And as a GM always tells me, Charles, this is a big boy league, and big people always end up winning games for you.
They run again on first down, Cook. And this will be taken across midfield and into Green Bay territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
The Vikings at 5-8, three games under 500. And they were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it two in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. And I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
That's some good tackling there to keep him short of that yellow line.
Yeah, and defensively, all I'm thinking is that on that play, get me to third down. Get me into a position where I can make one more play and get my defense off the field.
They'll run it. Here's Cook. And Cook was fighting for it, but I don't think he got there. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Remember, that was less than a yard. That was not a full yard. That defense, they were having none of it.
Yeah, the surge the offensive line was seeking actually occurred on the other side of the ball. They reestablished the line of scrimmage and stuffed them.
Running for it. Here's Cook. And boy, this is going to be close. That mark looks a little short. And he didn't get there. Talvin Cook turned away on fourth down. And the Packers D comes up with a big stop. So good field position for the Packers as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back there. They'll feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Rodgers now to throw. And that's off the mark, incomplete.
And he's missed now in his first four passing attempts. The rhythm is just not there to begin this ballgame.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Here's Rodgers to throw. That's into the hands of Edwards. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. So finally completes his first pass. Credit the defense, though. They've been showing him some different looks, keeping him off balance.
Yeah, I like the observation that you had there, because when you give him different looks and give any quarterback different looks, it takes just a little bit longer to process sometimes, and you don't throw the ball with the same confidence. You're not sure that that's where you should go with the football. And that's worked for the defense early in this game. And now he's got his first completion. Let's see if his confidence comes back, and he starts to get into a nice little groove.
Now here's a pass on first down. It's knocked away and incomplete.
The quarterback got away with one there. Looked like he was in line for a pick, but instead is knocked harmlessly to the turf.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. As he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three.
Well, this play sequence was really kind of called in reverse. Incomplete pass on first and 10. Nice run on second and 10 when probably everyone was expecting him to throw the football. Now, if you're the defense, what are they going to do on third down? You're a little off balance.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. He needed two. He got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down and a yard.
So many things go into making a good play on defense. In this situation, just not being blown out of the way was a big start, and then a nice tackle to finish things off.
They'll go with Jones. And he's not going to get there. Might have even lost a yard. He only needed a yard, but he couldn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. And the Vikings defense is going to get the football back. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. We've seen both of these offenses still sort of in that figuring things out phase, but I suspect some action on the scoreboard soon as they start out here first and 10.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
On second down, it's Cook again. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. They'll get four on second down, but it leaves them with third and still nine to go.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They're trying for Rager, but it's intercepted. And the Packers are going to take possession of the football.
Well, it's not the first time we've seen him give one up here during his rookie season. And in this case, zone coverage forced a mistake. He's made some strides week to week in how he's handling the different type of coverages that he's seeing. But clearly, there's some growing still to do.
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. He finds his man complete. That's Edwards. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short game.
Well, a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
I love those corners who can not only cover, but don't mind getting a little physical as well. How about the coverage on that play, knocking that pass away?
After the incompletion, here now, third and two. From the shotgun to give to Jones. He's going to be a yard short. Needed two, but only got one. Fourth down. He needed two, he got one, and that's going to leave him with fourth down and a yard. We're scoreless after one. Try. They'll put it down right at the 40, so call this a 50-yard attempt. And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. As the offense comes out here, Charles, maybe perhaps a bit more of a focus on the run game for this drive after tossing an interception on the previous one?
I think that's a good way to look at it and a good way to think about it, but maybe they get to it in a little bit different way, because after you throw an interception, you want to make sure you keep your quarterback's confidence high. So maybe give him a couple easy throws that he can complete and then get to the running game and try and get things settled down.
Yeah, and still in the first half here, a long way to go. Second down, they go right back to Cook. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and Give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there. And that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It's only a 3 yard run. But for both sides, they had to walk away from that field and like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Now Cook hit and he lost the football. And the Packers pick it up. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. Well, he has been a workhorse for them in this game. And ball security hasn't been an issue until that point.
Yeah, and let's face it. When he's going to carry the ball that many times, he becomes more and more of a target for the defense, knowing that he's going to be the primary guy. They'll just send more and more players towards him, trying to make sure they knock the ball free.
Now after the fumble recovery, it's Rodgers toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
That incompletion certainly slows things down a little bit and brings up a very important call for second and long. What do? Run and try and get some yardage and make it third manageable? And challenge the coverage again, hoping for a bigger game.
On second down, it's Jones. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
Not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Mucked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Open man left side. It's the tight end, DeGuara. And a nice job there defensively. They get him to the ground short of the first, right around the 42. A bad time for a roughing penalty. And they get the gift of a 1st and 10. From the gun, it's Rodgers. He has it complete to Christian Watson. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20.
A 6-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 4. The 21-yard line.
Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Rodgers. He finds his man complete. It's Edwards. And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked by Ronnie Harrison. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Well, it turns out it's not their offense who gets him on the board first, CD. It's the defense coming through right there with a pick six.
And I know from experience throughout the week, when you go against the offense, you're challenging them all the time. You let them know, hey, don't worry about scoring this week. We'll take care of it. We'll get a few pick sixes and score ourselves. You're just kidding? But how about what he just did right there? Laid it out for the rest of the game. We scored. Hey, offense, can you keep up with us?
No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, Patton, I think.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked up by the USC man, Adoree Jackson. And the Vikings are going to take over once again, and they'll have it at their own 8-yard line. They start the drive with Cook. And he loses the football a 2nd time.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Up the middle, Nwangu. Showed some strong running, but quickly corralled just beyond the 10-yard line.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. Another run now for Nwangu. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of one. And here's Ryan Wright now as he'll kick it away for the second time. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. So a change of possession here on the punt. And they will take over first and 10. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway.
And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown. Even later into his career now, there aren't too many guys that can launch it downfield with accuracy better than Aaron Rodgers.
And as that ball was hanging in the air with the receiver streaking downfield to meet it, here in the stadium, you can just sense the crowd thinking, oh, no. And their worst fears were realized as that one turned into a long touchdown.
And the final number of the next-gen stats, that ball traveling a full 59 yards through the air.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. As we eke closer and closer to intermission, Charles, remember last time out they punted. They would love to get points here, especially if this is going to be their final possession of the first half.
Yeah, and this is what close games feel like, because the pressure is on both sides, but sometimes the pressure is a little bit higher on the team with the slight edge because they're trying to hold on to that, trying to increase it. Let's see how this one continues.
-7, our score. Here's second and a yard. Another tote for the workhorse this afternoon. It's Cook, and he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 66 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here in this first half.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
On first down, they'll run with Nwangu. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
On second down, Cook. And he's got it up over the 40 to the 41.
But you got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball, because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
The Packers bringing in an extra member of the secondary here to try for the third down stop. Langford. Now the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. This is brought in at the 21. Now a hit and a loose football. And now off to the races down the right side. So not only do they get the fumble recovery on the... Look at this field position. He almost took it the distance.
And the ability to not just make the play, but turn it into something big, that's what coaches harp on all the time. How do we create big plays that'll change the game? And that may have been one that just did.
They'll go with the keeper, and he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. It's their quarterback in the final seconds of the first half. And the Vikings have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. Joseph connects on the extra point, and the lead is now 14-10. Time for one play on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And with Rodgers behind center, you wonder if they'll take one shot at this. The first play of the drive there is incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure you give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They're giving him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off for the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of his first half of play. So we've reached halftime here in Minnesota with the Vikings on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action, ready for the third quarter. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard as they begin the third quarter here, trailing and looking for a little momentum.
Yeah, you're right about that because, you know, let's face it, in the first half, most of their focus was in the passing game, and to their credit, resulted in a healthy amount of yardage. So I would think that at halftime, they're going to anticipate that defense loosening up a little bit to try and cover the passing lanes. They've got to get the running game going, and there should be some gaps to run through now.
Meanwhile, Rodgers' throw brought in by Watson. Just a gain of a couple there. Third and seven now.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Now it's Rodgers. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he's going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Throwing is Rodgers. The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. Danielle Hunter racking up sack number 12 for him on the year. Tell you what, he did not have much time there to skid in the field before he was ducking and covering.
Did it appear to you, as it did to me, that the defensive front won their play really quickly? Meaning the guys in front of him had almost no chance to block him. They were on him in a hurry.
He's going to loft one deep left side here. And this is caught. It's a big play there for Green Bay. 66 yards.
Well, he's been doing this for a lot of years with the arm strength still there, and he showed it off on that one.
After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal.
Jones will score. Touchdown, Packers.
Nice job of polishing off that drive, but all the credit there goes to that play prior.
Yeah, it certainly does, because after that big play, I think resistance almost felt futile at that point, didn't it? And the very next play, they come right back, quick, fast, and in a hurry, and put it in the end zone.
Johnson for the extra point try.
It's good, and they'll take a 17-14 lead.
Makes the score, Packers 17, Vikings 14.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they'll be working from behind now following the touchdown a moment ago on the opening drive of the half.
I think the guys right now, as they go out on offense, they're zeroing in on one big key. They don't have to do anything differently just because they're down on the scoreboard now. The intent, still the same in what they plan to do on offense.
The last run got a couple here, second and eight. They'll go right back to Nwangu. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Finding room at midfield.
And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I like the play design there. They occupied the defense downfield. Everyone trying to account for someone. But unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield. And he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
And he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43.
79 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
A good run got seven on first. Here's second and three. They'll try the middle with Cook, and he'll only get a yard to bring up third and one.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Third down, Dalvin Cook. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. That right there, a good sign for a team that's had trouble converting third down so far this year. They're in the bottom five in the NFL, but they come through there.
Yeah, and I bet if we put our guy Marvin on the case and say, Marvin, tell us where they rank on third and what, right? I bet they're in the top five in the league on third and five, third and six, third and seven or more, because that's how you end up not converting. Just too much yardage to pick up on third down.
Rashawn Gary, the man to bring him down.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that gain.
On second down. Here's Nwangu. And he'll follow his blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. They get 14 there. First down, Vikings. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up.
Sometimes with the running game, you just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Straight ahead, here's Nwangu. And a couple of yards as they move it from the 21 to the 19.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
Off the play fake, Langford. That'll be complete to the running back, Nwangu. That he won't quite make it. He needed six. He got about five. Fourth down.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? Third down, they just said, we've got faith in our tackles. We'll give you the short stuff, and just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
This rookie quarterback is paramount for this team. So you're exactly right. Every rep, doesn't matter what the game, what the situation, what the score, valuable for him, valuable for his team as they look towards next year.
And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They had seized the lead there for a little bit with a starting drive in the third quarter, but a moment ago, the touchdown that puts them back behind.
So their defense is under siege a little bit right now because they have not able to solve their opponents. They've got to keep hammering away on offense and try and win this one in what appears to be a shootout.
Set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. The Vikings going to signal for the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Second down, another shot for Jones. And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47. Now a first down carry by Jones. And he's got room. The 20. Touchdown, Packers. Plenty of scoring here of late, and our lead changes hands now in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they just gave up a touchdown the other end, so they knew that with time getting short, they had to put something together here, and they were able to do so and retake the lead right back.
Vikings 21.
So the Packer kickoff team set to go as they will kick this one away. And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown. Their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. 95 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. The give is Nwangu. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of three.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he's trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Cook up the gun. And he'll pick up about 3 there, up to the 43.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
Third down, here's a run by Cook. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. And here's Ryan right now as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. At their own 20-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to carry the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds. Because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? An ideal spot here to get a first down and try to run some more clock. And this is second and less than a yard. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Parker, for once in my life, I'll be succinct. In a one-possession game, every single stop like that could be a difference maker.
The Packers on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. 4 yards on the pickup, good enough to extend the drive.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation. And taking care of the football, paramount. He got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. And out across midfield, down to the 45. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And he'll manage to pick up about 4 in second down.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old golf drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
Well, the objective there, and yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but works in clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
Setting up the screen here, Aaron Jones. And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely, maybe by a half a foot. It'll be fourth and inches.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Well, they don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. They'll run it with Jones. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he works his way forward to pick up 4 yards there, second down.
But he picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. Again, it's Jones. And he's able to work his way down inside the red zone to the 19-yard line. 139 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens things up for you.
They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
So second and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. Here's a give to Jones running left. And he's going to ball his way down to about the 1-yard line. A nice run there, 8 yards, moves him much closer to the goal line now for third down. So it's all over. A Green Bay victory, and a little bit of a surprise they lose the turnover battle, but wind up winning the ballgame.
And this is very unusual because you know all teams stress winning the turnover battle as a key indicator to winning ballgames. So when you get something that goes against the grain like the one we saw here, it's quite the oddity. Now let's face it, they'll be very happy that they pulled this off. But they do know that in the future, they've got work on taking care of the football because this won't happen very often.
So for the Packers, the final 3 weeks are going to tell the story as they move to 9-5 on the year. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to the Windy City to take on the Bears. Meanwhile, for the Vikings, their slim playoff hopes are gone now as they fall to 5-9. And they'll have a tough one at home next week against the Denver Broncos.
And I keep getting stronger. My limit's the sky. I do the impossible, impossible.
Shine if I want to. I win every time if I want to. The world mine if I want to. Make the world mine cause I want to. I pull the sword out the border, walk a floor full of cobras. Go to war with you all, we can brawl toe to toe. I can tighten loops in my lace and make lightning lose in a race. I make fire cool and come back from the triangle in Bermuda. I can suit up, live in the moon up, working and outsmarting computers. I can outswim all the tuna, and that's without a scuba. So in the laws of nature, I'm breaking the rules. Only thing I'm bad at is being a loser. I can make time travel a surprise. Make graveyards feel alive. Break the immortal down to his demise. Look up and beam to the stars so you can turn off the lights. I come alive in the dark. And I keep getting stronger. Tonight I hunt with the pride. You can't take my pride away. I can sing with the birds and the trees in the morning. Or roll like the storms way over the ocean. My limit's the sky. I do the impossible, impossible. Shine if I want to. I win every time if I want to. The world mine if I want to. Make the world mine cause I want to.
Even on the days when I'm late as ever, my timing is right. Even in the darkest moments, stay close, I'm that shining the light. I can make an earthquake nervous, I can make the sun wear a visor. I can make a wise owl see me as a daily advisor. I'm that cool shade, peaceful night that still my breath is a storm. I bet I can make the thunder clap when I perform. It's just that in the laws of nature, I'm breaking the rules. Only thing I'm bad at is being a loser. Hey, I can make time traveling a surprise. Make graveyards feel alive. Break the immortal down to his demise. I make the moon blue. I'm making pigs fly. Now I move mountains. I would have beaten the heart of a crash test dummy. I'm more so astounded. Yeah. Look up and beam to the stars so you can turn off the lights. I do the impossible, impossible.
Be the end of me.
No, no.
Probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play. All these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency.
Let's go.
Don't make me jog your memory. I did upgrade you, then upgraded the world. How they forgetting me? Please make it make some sense to me. How you talking about the greatest? Still ain't mention me. Them bands, I want the symphony. 15 in it, went instantly. Lately I've been catching plays, it's like it's meant to be. I got rich in the pandemic, meant to be. Don't do too much, I keep it simple. You clout chasing, trying to make the people feel you. Boys need to slow it down, I'm talking real screw. Penthouse at the top with the clear view. Oh, look, I don't like your energy.
I don't like that.
I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. You an enemy.